Once my fiancé told me, you're bisexual who never had anything with men, and she's 100% right, but I wasn't always like that. Did my sexual orientation change because of transition, because of gender-affirming procedures, or because of the hormone replacement therapy? This phrase of my fiancé inspired me to dive deep into the topic of sexuality. Hi, I'm Kira, a transgender woman and counselor specializing in transgender care. The topic of sexuality appears in minds of most transgender people, and oftentimes it stops from transitioning because the only thought of being attracted to a different gender might be scary. Adult transgender people most likely already know what works for them and to whom they're attracted. These preferences are already well known and familiar, and they form the cornerstone of everyone's personality. What does science tell us about sexuality? It's a pattern of emotional, romantic, and sexual attraction, which describes to whom someone is attracted, sexually, emotionally, or both. It includes attraction to the opposite gender, to the same one, to more than one, or to a different gender. Common types of sexual orientation are heterosexual or straight, attraction to the opposite gender, homosexual, gays and lesbians, attraction to the same gender, bisexual, attraction to both men and women, pansexual, attraction to the person regardless of their gender, and asexual, little or no sexual attraction to others. The key points of sexual orientation are: it's not a choice. Usually it emerges in early adolescence. It can change for some people throughout their lives, and it's not dependent on gender identity. Scientists use the Kinsey scale to calculate the sexual orientation. It is ranked from 0 to 6, from heterosexual to homosexual. This scale might be outdated because it includes only two sexual orientations, but it's still widely used in research and surveys. How to read the Kinsey scale? 0 is exclusively heterosexual, 3 is equally heterosexual and homosexual, 6 is exclusively homosexual. So what is sexuality? It's a deeply personal experience and expression of people as sexual human beings. It includes emotions, relationships, behaviors, roles, and identities. Sexuality is a biological, social, cultural, and psychological term. People show their sexuality by behavior, active or abstinent, and it may not match their orientation. Sexuality also includes desires, fantasies, preferences, and tastes. They are formed by psychology, biology, and personal experience. Sexuality highly impacts our relationships with other people, how we love and connect with them, both physically and emotionally. Several factors like culture, social norms, religion, education, and media form a big part of sexuality. Once we understand what sexuality and sexual orientation are, let's talk more about what changes may transgender people experience during and after their transition. The common stereotype that sexual orientation changes after transition is not true, but not false either. Sexual orientation is mostly rooted to prenatal exposure to hormones and early years of development, but it may be impacted by psychological, cultural, physiological, and other factors. Transition consists of two parts, medical and social. By medical, we understand hormone replacement therapy and gender-affirming procedures. By social, we mean presenting and interacting with society as identified gender. There is no conclusive scientific evidence that medical transition changes sexual orientation. Research done in 2021 with over 900 participants, both trans women and men, found no direct impact of HRT on sexual orientation. On the other hand, another research done in 2005 found that 13% of trans women experienced complete change in sexual orientation after having sex reassignment surgery, from being exclusively attracted to women to being exclusively attracted to men. Research done in 2005 with over 450 participants found that 49% of transgender people experienced some shifts in sexual orientation after social transition. In other words, it means that there was a shift from being attracted only to one gender to a certain degree of bisexuality. Does gender transition change anything? Yes, HRT and gender-affirming procedures have a big impact on sexuality. Hormone replacement therapy physically changes brain structures, responses, and sensitivity. Because of these changes, trans women become more gentle, sensitive, and value more emotional connection with their intimate partner. Oftentimes, libido reduces during the first period of HRT, but then comes back in a different pattern. Orgasms may feel less concentrated in one spot and tend to come in waves through the body. The longevity also changes, and they become more prolonged, compared to pre-transition state. For trans men, the situation is opposite. Oftentimes, they adopt more active role, their libido rises, and orgasms feel more intense. Scientists have measured the quality numbers of orgasms for transgender people who have taken HRT for more than 1 year. For trans women, the time to reach orgasm increased from 7 minutes to 14. The duration also increased from 8 to 34 seconds. 72% of trans women reported of experiencing orgasms in new body parts, and also ability to achieve multiple orgasms. 74% reported an increase in the quality of orgasms. For trans men, there was also a significant change in duration from 15 to 29 seconds, and 67% reported of increased quality of orgasms. These changes happen due to physical body changes. For trans women, it's genital shrinkage, increased in sensitivity, and increased lubrication as a response to stimulation. For trans men, testosterone impacts clitoral growth, which also increases sensitivity. These facts are proved not only by science, but also by members of community. Trans women describe their experience as uncontrollable shaking and feeling it with the whole body. It's worth mentioning that these changes are more likely to happen, but not guaranteed. A 2024 study using MRI images of brain activity showed that arousal patterns changed from the assigned gender to the experienced one. Trans women and men felt arousal differently after starting transition. Talking about sexuality in transgender people, we can't skip the topic of gender dysphoria. It negatively impacts all aspects of life, including intimacy. This distress affects self-image, arousal, emotional intimacy, and satisfaction. Most transgender people have body incongruence. When they don't feel connected to their body, it feels alienated. This feeling may increase during sexual activities, which may result in emotional numbness, problems with achieving orgasms, shame and discomfort with genital touch, and avoidance of relationships. In committed relationships, gender dysphoria may lead to emotional distancing because of the risk of rejection from the partner. Transition, on the other hand, may reduce gender dysphoria. For many, it dramatically improves trust and emotional connection with the partner. Engaging, affirming, and more pleasurable intimacy, self-esteem, and connection with the body. With reduced gender dysphoria, many transgender people report being present during intimacy. Anxiety about how they are being perceived reduces, and sexual exploration of fantasies rises. We can clearly see that transition impacts sexuality in transgender people, and in most cases, this impact is positive. Sexual orientation may also change, but this experience varies from person to person. For better understanding of this topic, let's look how it can be applied in reality. Today, I'll be the subject of our research. Before transition, I was a heterosexual monogamous man who never had any experience or attraction to other men. For over 30 years, I was attracted only to femininity and women. My relationships after puberty were mostly long-term, with calm and stable intimate life. Sexual desires and fantasies were suppressed by dysphoria. I was ashamed to tell my partners about what attracted me and what other aspects I wanted to explore. Some attempts of sharing with them failed and were rejected or ignored. I always had a feeling of playing a role during intimacy and never felt relaxed. This role had to fully meet social expectations of how heterosexual men should behave. Additionally, I felt pressure from conservative family and culture. Body disconnection and shame also played a big role. But I thought the reason is excess weight, but not body dysphoria. Libido fluctuated and was mostly dependent on life circumstances. When I started medical and social transition, during the first 5-6 months, my libido was almost non-existent. It didn't cause any distress and mostly felt like liberation from a burden. Body changes, including the ones related to sexual characteristics caused by HRT, felt affirming and natural. In the third month, I started noticing some shifts in my sexual orientation. I began noticing men and their appearance. I was attracted not only to the idea of having a female role in relationships, but also being actually attracted to men. Genital dysphoria appeared in the second month and was constantly present with big intensity. Orgasms during the first stage of transition were mostly in male pattern, but in the fourth month, I experienced shift into a female pattern. After 6 months of transition, I met my partner and fiancé. It was a turning point in my sexuality. Libido started waking up and constantly grew. our emotional connection and progress in my transition raised my self-esteem. We're open to talks about intimacy and freely discuss any topics regarding it. Desires that were causing shame are no longer taboo. Behavior during intimacy is female, and as my fiancé says, there's nothing manly in you. For me, it was surprising because it comes naturally without forcing myself, and it is completely different from my old male experience. I can confirm that the feeling of presence is true. Orgasms are more prolonged, intense, and can be achieved multiple times. I experienced significant changes in arousal patterns. My sexual orientation also changed. I would say on the Kinsey scale, I lost 2 points. I am attracted to both men and women, but still have a preference for women. I haven't had any experience of relationships with men, but now I can clearly identify whom I find attractive. Now I'm a monogamous bisexual trans woman who is in long-term relationship with a woman. This experience feels absolutely natural to me, despite all the social pressure and old life. Answering the question, did my sexuality and sexual orientation change because of the transition? I would say yes, and I'm happy with it. Will it change for you? This is an open question. But I hope this video made this complex topic a bit clearer and less frightening. If you enjoyed this video and want to support my gender transition, you can donate for my sex reassignment surgery. You will find the link in the description below. Thank you for being with me. Please subscribe, hit the like button, and see you soon in my next video. Bye.